Hey y'all, so this is like part two of prom vlog. I hope y'all enjoyed the last one for March. Now we finna start on April. So far I only got two and I'm okay. So this dress we finna work on is a corset top, y'all. I don't know if I even gave y'all a story time about the last time I did a corset dress, but it was terrible. And I was scared to get into corset dresses, but I'm like, I won't learn. So, y'all know I work with patterns, and this corset top that I'm using is this pattern. Got it off of Etsy, right? Okay, so what we finna do is we finna make our own bra cups. And I did a lot of research. I looked into it a lot, different ways, all that kind of stuff. So, I got this fabric. I think they call this neoprene or something like this, but it's nice and thick, like a padded bra. But I'm gonna use this, cut this out, use it, and basically make like little bra cups. Then we're gonna move on to. First of all, this is the inspo right here. I'm putting the inspo right here. This is the inspo. Let me show y'all my material, because I ain't showing material. I showed y'all this already. So we got this like ivory type color for the bottom. Then this, she want this to go over it like this. So we got this, and then I got this fabric that I'm gonna try to, I don't know, probably sew on here some kind of way, which I personally don't think that she would need it, but I'm gonna put the dress together and see, because the dress is already doing a lot, it's already cute, and I feel like this is just gonna take away from it, and I don't know. So right now I'm gonna cut this out right now, and then I'll be back when I cut out my material out. I really don't feel like setting up the camera to do like a time lapse, so I'll just show y'all my material when I get it cut out. I'm sorry, I'm not in the mood right now, okay? So I'll see y'all in the next clip. So I came to a stopping point. This is my first time doing this, y'all, but I gotta give me one of them little ironing, you know, the little things that you put on the iron to make it like make the boob part, you know, go round. But this is what the inside look like, padded, and then this is what the outside look like. So I don't think it look too bad. It don't look too bad. Her boob is just a little bit bigger than this, so I think we're off to a good start, but I'm at my stopping point, so I'll see y'all on Monday. So it's not done. I'm still trying to, it looks a little crazy. I'm still trying to, I'm still working on it, but I'm kind of reaching a stopping point. It's not done, so I did the little lace. This actually came out better than I expected it to. Yeah, it's not bad for a first try. I feel like for a first try, it's not bad. I don't have it on there that tight, actually. And this is kind of not her body, what is it called? Her size. So it's a little off just a little bit. But I think this is a little big. The corset thing is a little big. So I don't know, I gotta fix it. But this is what I came up with. Okay, so this is just gonna be underneath. This fabric on top of it like this, so you won't really be seeing this, it's just gonna be underneath. But I'm gonna ask her if she want me to add more
if she want me to add lining underneath the like this part right here, because it's kind of gonna be showing. Not kind of, it is gonna be showing. I hope I'm not in the way. This fabric is heavy as heck. But yeah. So yeah. We have a staff appointment right now. I'm still trying to figure shit out. I wanna cry.
I'm about to cry. I'm not gonna cry. But okay, so change of plans. I made this corset, right? Showed it to her. She showed it to her mama. She want me to line it. I gotta go back and line it. Went back and lined it. Fucked it all up. Hold on, let me just prop the phone up so we can see. So now I just brought another goddamn pattern because, you know, I'm still trying to get the corset thing going. The original thing that I did, I used mesh and I cut it out on the non-stretch side, right? She wanted me to line it. I only got stretch fabric. I'm not going buy no more goddamn fabric. So I tried to use stretch fabric. It's not working out. It's looking a little crazy. So now I just went and bought another fucking pattern. I wasn't a fan of this pattern anyway, which is a waste of money. Just a waste of money. But we learned it. Bought another pattern. I gotta go print it out, cut it out, do everything over. I basically have to fucking do everything over. But that's okay, because it's a learning experience. Everything's a learning experience. But let me show y'all the shit show real quick. Hold on. Y'all probably look at this and be like, oh, it don't look bad. It doesn't fit. It don't look bad. From like this, it don't look bad, but it's not right. This looks like a shit. Everything, look the inside. Everything about this is just not it. Like, look at, like, I don't put work out like this. So that's kind of why I'm annoyed. But hey, that's why you make fucking samples. This is why you make samples before you make the real deal. So now here I am. Today is Tuesday. I want to have this dress done by Friday. No ifs, ands, or buts about it, because there's not much that I have to do. So why is it taking me so long to make this damn dress? But this is going in the trash. The boning, it's going in the trash because it's the shit show. It ran a good run. You know, it was a nice little good little sample. But I need to do my research on stretch fabrics with corsets and how much you have to take in, how to adjust the measurements, and then the same with non-stretch. So let's throw this fucking shit in the trash. See y'all. I don't even know when I'm gonna see y'all, because I don't know. So I brought my other mannequin here to the office and I adjusted it to her size, and I redid the whole thing, and this is how it came out. It don't look too bad, but it ain't the best thing in the world for me. But it don't look bad. And it's gonna be getting covered up with this fabric. So now I'm about to figure out how to do this, because the way that I see the Africans do it is they put it on top of the mannequin and then, you know, do that. But I'm not trying to do it like that, because the bottom, I want it to flare out just a little bit. And then I also don't want to cut it into pieces either. But it honestly looks like I might have to do that. I might have to cut it into two pieces and then put it together, because the way I wanted to do it, I wanted to do it in one piece, but I can't do it in one piece. I gotta do it in two pieces because I want the flare to come out. So I think what I'm gonna do is just fold this, you know how it go, and then set it on top of there and just cut it out, just freehand it, and then do the same thing for the back. So yeah, that's where we at. Oh, I don't know, I gotta get this together because when I come in tomorrow, I honestly wanna be finishing this up. So I wanna at least have this fabric cut out and, like, you know, have it placed in. And when I come in tomorrow, all I gotta do is put it together, sew it, and then I will probably move on. Cause I feel like with this dress, like, this fabric is enough. But I know on her inspo it has like some gold, I mean not some gold, some silver little stones and stuff, and that's what I got right here. But I honestly don't think that she would need it, for real. I think that's kind of gonna throw it off. And I was gonna make her dress go the other way, but I'm like, no, this is cute, it just don't stretch this way. And that's another thing, y'all. So I don't know, but we finna just finna put it together, we finna see. So I think I got more than enough fabric of this. I don't know, y'all, because part of me want to just fold this in half and then just cut it out. I don't know, I really don't know. I'm stuck right now, so I'll talk to y'all later. Okay, y'all, so what I did was I'm laying it down this way, right? And then I got one of my the Karen pattern. I got her pattern and marked where she started for it to start coming out, like flaring out, where she started the mermaid part at. So I marked that right here, right? Boom, boom. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave an inch on both sides. So half an inch for the zipper, and then another half an inch is just for the seam allowance on the side, right? So that's 1 inch on both sides. So then I'm just trying to measure how I'm letting it come down, because she don't want that much of a dramatic train, and I also don't want to use up too much fabric just in case I need to, you know, do this again and it don't come out right. But I think I'm gonna be good. I still don't want to use that much more fabric just in case I need to, you know, do this again. So I'm finna mark up my inches on the side and then start right here and try to, like, mark the train to where it, you know, ends right here. So yes, this update. When I cut the pieces out, I didn't cut the back part out yet. I just left it like this, and I'm probably just gonna fold it down and then just cut it first instead of cutting it first. I'm probably just gonna, you know, put the dress together, fold it down, you know, do it like that. But I think it's gonna be so cute. And I gotta do the zipper. So then when I do the back piece, I need to cut it. So I honestly need to see which piece is gonna be the back piece, and then cut it in half so I can have two pieces. But yeah, update. Ever since I left the city. Okay, y'all, so I finished. Well, it's not finished because I'm still trying to figure out that part right there. Like, the zipper is on here. The zipper is on here, but I have to figure out. I just probably have to just top stitch or hand sew this down, pin it, and then just sew it down. But this is what it looked like. I'm pinning. See how this is, like, open up around here? I had cut some, because I still have some of this. I had cut some out and just to pin it right up there where the parts are open at. And yeah, this is what the dress looked like. She didn't want, like, no dramatic train. She just wanted, like, a elegant look. My mannequin is her measurements, but I don't know, it just look a little weird. Like, it don't got enough boobs. I'm pretty sure she got way more boobs than this to fill it out. But even if she don't, I feel like she can put a bra on or something like that and then, you know, just fill it out. Cause my baby girl ain't got no boobs, so it's not sitting right. But yeah, I don't know, y'all. What y'all think? That's the back. It's, I don't know. So I put the dress on this mannequin, but I think I'm gonna get some clear straps, because I feel like this fabric is so heavy that it's like keeps sliding down. And I know she ain't got no body, but I still feel like I should put some clear straps so her boobs won't be popping out. But this is how it looks on my mannequin, y'all. Neither one of these mannequins got no chest. But I don't know. So, I don't know where I left off, but basically, I think I had showed my client the dress. Y'all know I had started over because, her mom said she wanted it lined. So, I ended up starting it over, redoing it, putting it all together, and whatever this face is, whatever. I ended up starting over, putting it all together, and she was like, can I make the top part go in deeper? And I'm just like I'm speaking to y'all from a designer's point of view. And if you take it, we all gonna take it how we want to take it. That's fine, that's cool with me. But like, I don't know, this is just making me not want to, and I don't want to be speaking negative, so I might not even, because I try to just stay negative free, just leave that shit up in the air to people who like that. But I don't think I want to be doing customs next for the rest of whatever. However, I don't think I want to do any custom, especially custom prom dresses next year, because it's not all the time. Like, most of my girls are very, you know, I don't know, understanding in me not wanting to make the same thing, and me to seeing like what I make is not gonna look like your picture. And most of these girls, most of y'all, if this is you, I'm talking to you. Most of y'all see these inspos on these mannequins or on these girls with these wide ass hips, in these flat ass stomachs, and these nice perky titties, and think, yes, it's not gonna look like that on you if that is not your body type. We have to learn to dress our body type, you know. Research your body type, you know, trial and error with the clothes that matches your body type, because you're not finna put that pressure on me because I'm making something, I made what you wanted and it don't look right on your body. Okay, so yeah, so back to my client. I showed it to her. She wanted me to make the top part go in deeper, but the dress is already done. Like, I'm not going back because it was my second time redoing it already. And it's like, when y'all come to us with the customs, make sure y'all have y'all details all together, because I know y'all be in school, so y'all can't always respond. Like, our timing is always different, but that's why I try to get all my details and get everything together, so when I am getting something, it's not like I'm waiting. So I wasn't restarting the dress over, and she want like stones. I mean, she wants some rhinestones on there. Did I show y'all the rhinestones? I got it right here. I really didn't want to take this out, but obviously I gotta show y'all. So I had about 2 appliques, y'all, and honestly I just feel like I did not charge my worth for this dress. I didn't charge what I should have charged, which is fine, which is okay with me, because sometimes stuff just be like a learning experience, and I'm paying for that. Like, I'm paying for my learning experience, and through all of that I just have to think like, this is a learning experience, let's just get through it, correct our mistakes, and just keep it pushing, right? So I ended up buying this. This was $250 a yard, y'all. I ended up getting this fabric. I ended up getting this rhinestone fabric. And then I gotta take it out the thing, y'all. I don't feel like taking it out the thing. And then I ended up getting this rhinestone. I mean, this applique. And I'm trying to see like which one she want to choose. I love how this is, but which one she want me to use on the dress, and she want me to combine them. And like, I'm not, this at the end of the day, this is my work also, so I'm not finna do something and I know damn well it ain't gonna look right. So I'm letting her know, and I know some people be like, no, like just do what I want, but it's like, I have no problem sending nobody their money back. Like, I have no problem sending their money back. I have no problem, you know, taking my L. Because I'm not going to... It's still my work at the end of the day. So, you know, I try to... What is it called? My brain be having brain farts. I try to, like, just redirect them and just help them out with their design. Because sometimes the stuff that they, because I, visual wise, I think I'm pretty good with that. So she want to combine both, and I just feel like it's not really gone. It's going to take away from, if you put too much, it's going to take away from this fabric. Then you won't really be able to see it. But I think she's trying to get so close to the inspiration, which is, I don't want to do that. So I'm trying to like just stir her a little bit, while still also being polite. And I don't want her to feel, you know, a certain way, because I know through text messages, stuff can be so misconstrued through a text message. But I'm just want to, like, I you know, even in the beginning, I was telling her, like, I'm going to take care of you. Like, I'm not going to have you out here looking crazy. I got you. But I just feel like doing both is just going to take away, and then it's just going to be all this. And if that's the case, we could have just did this, and then that's it. So now I'm just waiting on her to respond. So while I'm waiting on that, I am finna start working on my other dress for April. I said all that just to come and tell y'all we finna start working on our other April prom dress and get that done and out the way while we waiting on the response from her. So she want a black velvet dress, and she want like some mesh at the bottom with an applique on the front. I got the applique over there, black applique, and then she want a glove, which is pretty straightforward, you know. It probably won't take me that long to make. So we're gonna put this dress to the side. I put that dress to the side, y'all. I put her to the side over there, and we finna work on this black dress. I don't like when I be in positions like this, because, like, I don't know. And then I paid $250 for this, and then $107 for that one. I am not finna be cutting into both of these and wasting it. And I put it all together, hand sew everything on there, and it's like, oh, I don't like that. Like, make sure you are 100%. Because when it comes to putting something together and then having to go back and take it all apart, I'm not doing that. Here is my material, my black velvet. I got my applique right here. I got all my mesh right here. pattern with my glove, and then I got my horsehair. Put the horsehair at the bottom. So yeah, this is pretty straightforward. We're about to cut out all the material, get the sketches. I mean, get like the, put the top together. I'm gonna put the top together, and then I come back and do the bottom, because doing that damn circle, doing this bottom with this circle skirt and shit with these measurements and all this, it be. Because I'm gonna be, I like, see, that's another thing, right? I want the circle skirt to go into the dress, but because I'm gonna be cutting, kind of cutting off the bottom of the dress, wait though, I probably can still do it. Let me see. Because she want the bottom of the dress, not the whole bottom though. So I probably could keep it to where it's like together and just use Karen's mermaid pattern, because I don't like the seam at on the circle skirt, and if it's not being covered up, I don't like that. I don't want it to be seen. So I think I'm gonna figure out where I could keep it seamless and just cut like, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna put this up and then I'm gonna go back. But yeah, I'll see y'all whenever I see y'all. I got glitter all over my face, everything, baby. Her bottom, according to the pattern I'm using, her bottom is extra small, right? My other, with this pattern that I got, her bottom is a small medium, but this pattern, her measurement, her hip is a extra small, which I'm trying to figure out if I want to do a small or not. Hold on y'all, let me figure this out first before I explain this. Okay, I'm back. So according to her measurements with that pattern over there, Karen's pattern, she, her hip is a extra small to small. I was gonna do this extra small, but I'm like, I think I'm gonna do a small. If anything, I can always take it in if I need to. So I'm gonna do a small. So what I'm gonna do is, because this is like a midi dress pattern right here, I'm going to cut out my top pieces, because I'm not a fan of the neckline of the top pieces for the, for this pattern, the Karen's mermaid pattern, but I like the neckline for, from this pattern. So what I always do is just cut the top part off, just make its own separate pattern, and then attach it to this, her bottom, because I like her bottom, of course. So what I'm finna do is, I just explained it, shit, I'm finna trace this out, cut this out, and then when I cut the pattern out, because I don't want a seam in the middle, I'm gonna just put them, you know, connect them together like it's one, and then just cut it out into one, and then go back and then just fix whatever I need to fix. So yeah, I'll be back. Okay y'all, so we opted where she wanted to do the full mesh top, and then we did the bottom like this, and then she got a mesh at the bottom right here too. And look how good that looks. Like, it looks so clean. See how clean that look, y'all? And it's going around, but it's also slanted too. Yeah, we'll see whenever I put it all the way together. But it looks so good. So, and then let's turn it to the back, because we gotta show the stitches. We gotta show how good the stitches look. Yeah, I remember that I didn't have a zipper. I don't have a black zipper, so I gotta go get a zipper. And then for this white dress, she ended up responding back, and honestly, I don't like to do this, but then again, it just be like, this is what I gotta do. I think I'm going to just go with my move and do the dress how I think it's cute, because I don't know, like, I got the dress hanging up right here, and I really do think that she needs, I'm finna go to the store right now and get what is it, zipper, And I'm gonna get some clear straps for her because I really do think she needs some clear straps because that fabric is heavy. It's heavy and it's pulling down, it's dragging down. And then we're finna put more. I got glitter all over my face. Then we're finna put more stuff on there. So it's gonna be really heavy. So I really feel like a clear strap. I'm gonna put a clear strap on there because I don't wanna it to be falling off and then her titties popping out and then not doing that. But I'm so excited for this black dress because it's gonna be super cute. Like this part look like underwear. it look like some drawers. But this update, y'all, I will see y'all later. Okay, y'all, so she wasn't really specific on how she wants this place. I'm annoyed with this dress, y'all. I'm not gonna lie. Like, these silver pieces look so... For $250 a yard, the quality is not that good. It's gooey, sticky, like it was freaking glued on there. Good thing I had this left over from a long time ago that I just found in my thing. And I think that helped out a lot. I mean, I don't know, like... The dress is already doing too much, so it's not really much that you can do to it. And she want bedazzling and stuff on there. So, I don't know. I'm going to send this to her, see what she think. And I'm done with the dress. Here I go again, sucking and recording. But we got the base done. So, I'm going to tell her to, whenever she's available, to come over so she can try it on. And then we can move on to the final step. Here is the gloves right here. And then that's the applique right there. So I'm gonna tell her she come over whenever she have time to try on the dress so I can make sure the placement is good, coverage is good, blah, 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 blah. And then, yeah, this white dress, y'all, she ain't like it. She told me she didn't like it. When it was? That was yesterday. Yesterday, she texted me and said she didn't like it. And she wanted to use the other applique. But I'm like, mm-mm. Like in my head. I mean, not in my head, but I'm just like, basically like, no. Because I'm not going to keep cutting. We know when we don't like something the minute we see it, right? So, I kind of have a feeling that she didn't like the dress the minute that she seen it. But she probably thought, okay, let me just wait and just see with the rhinestones if it's going to look better. And it's like, at that moment, like, express, please, I don't care. Like, let me know. Let me know the minute, every thought that you get, let me know, tell me, because I want to know, because I'm here to make sure that you're good. And then at the same time, this is my brand. Like, I need to make sure my brand is good, make sure, you know, like, everybody is good. You happy, I'm happy. So, say she don't like it. She wanted me to see how it looked with the other applique, but I wasn't finna cut that applique, that good applique, and then put that on there. And then she said, oh no, I don't like that one either, because I already just wasted this $250 yard fabric because I cut into it, you know, and she don't like it. So she asked how much would it be upcharged to do a new dress. And me being me, because I want to take care of everybody, I want to take care of you. Like, I want you to have a good experience with me. So if you don't like it, her prom is in 2 weeks, y'all. I'm like, I have another dress to do, but you know, I'm open because I want to make sure it's her last prom. Her prom is in 2 weeks. I want to make sure that she good. I told her and her mom to give me a call. Today is the next day. I still haven't gotten a call. I'm waiting on the call. Today is Monday. Her prom is like, I think 2 weeks from today. Like, literally 2 weeks from today. I have another dress to do. And it's like, I'm not going to run behind my clients. I will not run behind y'all. If y'all send me y'all money, I have your money. So, I will hope that, you know, we the communication is there and it's good. So I haven't gotten a call from her or her mom yet. I'm just waiting on that so that we can talk on the phone, because I feel like I think I've said this before, like through text, things just get so misconstrued and not doing that. So I wanted to talk on the phone, talk to mom, talk to her, and just see like what I can do, what we can do. And, you know, we only got 2 weeks. What can we do? What we gonna do? Because I feel like on my end, I think she just, this is why I kind of like to, I like for my clients to be open-minded and let me kind of, you know, you give me the overall and then let me kind of, you know, do it my way, but then making sure that you like it too at the same time. But this way, it was just like, she just wanted it this exact way. And I'm like, okay, I'm gonna back back. I'm gonna do it exactly how you want me to do it. And then I did that and it's like, okay, no, I don't like it. I check myself, make sure I ain't do nothing wrong. I ain't say nothing wrong. Like it, I'm not at fault. So I don't know y'all, but she's, you know, we moved on because she's due this month too in April. Today's April 1st. She's due this month too in April. But this dress, I'm going to text them again today and let them know, you know, like, I don't want to wait too late because then the pressure is going to be put on me to make you a new dress or whatever it is, whatever we got to figure out. So, yeah, that's what we at. I'll see y'all when I see you. Okay, y'all, so the dress is done. I just have to finish up her sleeve. And then she gonna come do a final fitting. And then we'll be done with this one. And we can start on our final one. Here's an update on the white dress that is will no longer be made in this video. So, you know, I was just making, just basically, I feel like I didn't have too much control with this dress. Like, usually with my clients, like, I suggest stuff, you know, just to, like, deteriorate from shit looking the same, because I'm not fin to create the same. I'm not doing no recreations. I'm not recreating. Like, that's not what I want my brand to be. I want my brand to be me, you know, making my own version of stuff. So you send me a inspo, the style. Yes, I got the style. I can do that style, but I'm going to do my own version. So I kind of think that this client kind of was still, was, she was like, okay, I get it. Yes, I understand. But then, she, you know, in the back of her head, she was still like, but I want the dress to look like this, but she wasn't telling me. But so when the dress did not look exactly like the picture, she like, oh no, I don't like it. So I'm just like, okay, so what can I do? Because like, I'm very understanding and I don't want to be the reason why somebody day goes to shit. I don't want to. Like, I want to make everybody happy. I want to make my clients happy. I want to make sure everybody's good. So I'm like, you know, tell me what you don't like. She like, I don't like it. Would it be an upcharge for a new dress? Blah, blah, blah. And y'all, my contract says non-refundable. Like, once I get the payment, there's no refund because of situations like this. And honestly, I'm still learning. And I know, like, not all of you, my sweet little precious little babies, not all of you, but most younger adults are very indecisive and they are very, what is it called, influenced by the media. So y'all really don't be understanding, like, you know, you see something on a mannequin or on a model and you like, I like it, but you have to think about like the build. You have to think about if you're built like, if y'all have the same body type. So I'm thinking that she, and I did get a few from other designers, like a few constructive criticism, and I noted everything. Somebody was telling me like how my fabric wasn't aligned. I'm like, okay, you know, I see that, noted, like, fine. But she was already done. Like, instead of, you know, coming to me with the problem and giving me a chance to like fix it, even though I said I wasn't going to be redoing the dress again, but I'm like, you know what, this is my job basically. But she was like over it. Like, she was like, no, I'm basically like, she don't want to proceed. She out of $600, this is her senior prom, blah blah blah. Even though I wanted to do a phone call with her and mom, I didn't hear nothing back from nobody. No phone call, no nothing. I just got a text saying, I'm out of $600, I don't want to proceed, this is my senior prom, blah 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 blah. So I sat on that message for a minute, talked to my husband about it, talked to other designers about it, just to see their opinion, and just giving them backstory, and just to see, you know, how they will handle it. And a lot of people were telling me like, I wouldn't give no money back, because I'm like, I'm just gonna give money back because I don't want to be the reason why somebody's big day goes to shit. A lot of people was telling me don't get no money back because you already put the time in, which I did. I did put the time in, but still, I'm just feeling like I don't want to be that person. So, sat on that message. Even though I asked, what can I do to fix it? She offered for a new dress. I'm like, yeah, I'll make a new dress. I wasn't even going to charge that much to make a new dress. She don't know that, but, you know. And I sat on it and I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna send the money back and I'm just gonna be done with this situation. Like, no bad blood, no bad energy. Like, I'm, you know, I'm giving you your money back and there's nothing. Like, you figure your stuff out. You got your money, you ain't lose no money. I lost out on money, but I'm fine with it. So I didn't even get a thank you, y'all. I ain't even get a, like, thank you, or appreciate you, or even though I'm pissed off, you know, I appreciate you for nothing. Just, they got their money, and that was it. Okay, fine. So, that's the end of that. And I'm not down talking anybody. I'm just speaking on my side of the situation and how it went on my end. She probably got a whole different experience, a whole different way that it was to her, went to her, looked to her. But that's her piece and her version. I'm just speaking my side. And I've learned, and I'm still learning, and that's fine. Learn how to handle situations. And yeah, I'm going. So that's the update on that dress. I redid it. I took it all apart. And I'm going to redo it my way. Like, I started working on it, and y'all, it's coming together really cute because I'm doing it my way. But I'm redoing the dress just to prove to myself, like, you got this. You got this. Like, no. Because when stuff like this happen, I be so discouraged, y'all. But this is just a part of the business. So, yeah, that's the update on that. But I still have my other April dress, which is what y'all seeing now. I think last video y'all seen was her doing her try on. She was so happy, and those are the moments that I live for. So yeah, that's the update. And I don't know, I think this might be the end of the April vlog, because which wasn't much, nothing much. After this video, y'all just gonna see her pictures, and just like, you know, just keep watching. But right now, make sure y'all comment, subscribe, and share with y'all friends, and be on the lookout for the May vlog, because I was excited for the brown dress on my last vlog. Very excited for this one because it's my favorite color. So yeah, see y'all. Peace, love, and blessings. Ever since I left the city.